So we are in one of the laboratories for neurodynamics, and here we're focused mainly on doing anatomical imaging of mouse brains. Basically doing 3D imaging of mouse brains with really fine resolution. Here we have a number of different microscopes. One of them here is called a mesospim, which stands for a mesoscale selective plane illumination microscope, which is a mouthful, but I think Lightsheet microscope means a lot more sense. And the way that the microscope works is you shine a sheet of light through the brain and then you take pictures of that sheet of light.
So I shoot a laser from the side and it's a thinner line. And from this side, you basically see like a width of the line, and that's how we call it, form the sheet. And so the camera is capturing whatever the sheet illuminates the area, and so it will turn into a nice image.
So what you're actually seeing is the result of a laser that has scanned across the field of view and only imaged a bright spot in a very small chunk of the sensor. It's kind of like looking through the world through like a straw, and then we've collected that over time to create one picture.
All of the bright areas that are lit up, that's where the dye is, and that's being hit by that light sheet, and then we're imaging the dye molecules, which are essentially lighting up where the neurons are and where the neural connections are. That's really what we're after. We're trying to understand how different brain regions connect to one another. We also have really fantastic groups that are doing electrical physiology, so measuring electrical activity from awake mice, as well as optical physiology, where we're actually imaging light firing in awake mice as well. Really, the goal of neurodynamics is to tie all of these experiments back to behavior and really understand an actual behavior of a living mouse. And ultimately, that information can allow us to understand how the brain works and ultimately how to cure or understand disorders when the brain isn't working.